Hello, I'm Steven Thomas and I'm a podiatrist, which is a foot and ankle specialist, and I'm based mainly in Harley Street in London. In this video, I'm going to go through the foot bones and talk to you about the associated problems that I see regularly in clinic. Starting at the end of the foot, we have the toes, also known as the phalanges. Now these comprise of bones called phalanxes. Each toe has three phalanxes, except for the big toe, which only has two. These are called the proximal phalanx or the distal phalanx. On the lesser toes, there is the proximal phalanx, intermediate phalanx, and the distal phalanx. With the toes, common problems that I see in clinic can involve bunions with the big toe, or what we call a bunionette, which is a mini version on the fifth toe on this side. You can get hammer toes, particularly on the second toe if it's the longest one. Hallux rigidus, which is in the joint of the big toe, which is some arthritic changes here. And of course, fractures. The most common fracture I seem to see with stubbing toes seems to be fracture of the proximal phalanx of the fifth toe. Moving more proximally, you have the five metatarsals. And these are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Common problems that I see with these bones include bunions. Now with a bunion, you get a deviation of the first metatarsal, which progressively swings out this way. And then also the big toe will progressively swing out this way and move inwards. So you end up with this angulation. You can get something similar on the fifth metatarsal, which is what we call a bunionette, where this one will swing out a little bit, more of an angle like this. And then the toe will swing out like this. The other one that involves the first metatarsal is the sesamoid bones underneath. These can become fractured, but more often than not, you can get what we call sesamoiditis, which is inflammation of these, usually from overloading. The second metatarsal is the longest metatarsal in the foot, and because it's the longest one, it does take a lot of pressure underneath the second joint. A stress response in the bone, it could be synovitis of the joint, it could be damage to the plantar plate underneath the joint. The third and the fourth metatarsals, I seem to see a lot of stress response in here, so you get stress fractures or bone bruising in these bones. Now the fifth metatarsal on the outside is a common one to become fractured. Now this is called the styloid process, and it does protrude quite a bit. So if you do have an ankle inversion injury and your foot goes over, there's a lot of pressure that goes through this part. And also the peroneus brevis tendon does come around this area, comes down and inserts into this point. So any soreness around here could be the peroneus brevis, it could be where it's inserting here, could potentially be a fracture across this area here as well. Now, more proximal to the metatarsals are the cuneiforms. So there's the first, intermediate, and lateral cuneiform. Around the first cuneiform and the first metatarsal, there are problems with this area. You can get arthritic changes in this joint, particularly the second one, and also something called a Lisfranc injury, which can involve around here or across these bones here. Moving across laterally from the cuneiforms, there's a cuboid bone. I do see quite a lot of stress response in this area, but also the other thing to look out for is the peroneus longus tendon does come round and tuck underneath here. So if there is pain along this area, it may be the bone, but it could also be the tendon that wraps underneath. More proximal to the cuneiforms, you have the navicular bone. It articulates with the cuneiforms and with the talus. Now the tuberosity around here, roughly where the blue point is where the posterior tibial tendon comes around and then it inserts into this point. This can be a problematic area, which can involve the tendon that's inserting. Sometimes you can get an accessory bone in this area as well. That's something else to look out for. This is the ankle area, which involves the fibula, the tibia, and underneath you have the talus. Problems in this area could be a number of things. On the fibula, you have three main ligaments that attach around here and the bottom at the back. The most common area is here, the ATF ligament. Pain around this area, though, may be the ligament. It may be a fracture in the lateral process of the talus. It could also be a fracture at the lateral malleolus or the tip of the fibula. So careful examination needs to be carried out. This is the heel bone around here. It's a large bone. and it does take a lot of stress. So when we walk, we do land with our heels. You can fracture the heel, particularly if you've jumped from a height. But the two main things that I see with the heel problems, the plantar fascia inserts into this area, and also the Achilles tendon that inserts at the back. I hope you found that video useful. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.